Yes, I finally beat it.
Got that dopamine rush, eh, Henry?
Dopa who?
You know, the chemicals in your brain that get increased when you do something you love.
There's chemicals in my brain?
Come on.
Candace, where are we going?
On a magical learning adventure.
Oh boy!
And it's good to be alive. To feel the wind in my face. See the blue in the sky. It stays like
that's Sheila. Nothing makes her happier than singing.
It's good to be alive.
You nailed that. That was so good.
Well, cool. Because my throat can't take any more.
Check the cabinet. There should be pain relievers or something.
How many?
I think like two.
Well, Henry, do you want to see Sheila's brain?
Do I want to? Whoa!
Here we are. Looks nice and healthy.
Those are some weird-looking flowers.
They're neurons. They're the cells that make up your brain. And that water isn't water, so don't drink it. That stream is dopamine, the chemical I mentioned before. Dopamine gets released when you do something you enjoy, like singing or beating a video game. Dopamine and other chemicals flow from one neuron to the next to keep your brain functioning normally.
Oh. Wait, why is the dopa stuff going down?
Don't worry, that's normal. We got here when there was a high amount of dopamine because Sheila was happy to be singing. I like to call that her life high.
Her life high? Huh.
Now that she stopped singing, the dopamine is going back to its usual level. Actually, she wouldn't want there to be much more dopamine than that, because that would mean... Uh-oh.
What's happening?
She must have taken too many pain relievers! They're often drugs called opioids, and they can make your brain release far more dopamine than it can handle. This could last hours.
So what do we do?
Here, let me show you something.
Where are we? The dopamine is way lower than Sheila's brain, and lots of flowers are gone.
This is Derek's brain. He's a couple years younger than Sheila, and he's been taking opioids much longer. He's had lots of floods, like we just saw, and each time many neurons got washed away. The ones that are left release less dopamine too.
Less dopamine? Shouldn't they release more, since there's not as many?
It's the worst of both worlds. The neurons have gotten used to getting all their dopamine chemically from opioids instead of naturally from things he enjoys. Derek has taken greater and greater doses to reach the same high as the first time. However, with less neurons releasing less dopamine, his brain needs drugs just to reach the level that life had given him before he ever took them.
But the drugs are what messed it up!
Exactly. That trickle down there is all he can get, even with drugs.
Jeez. Do other drugs work the same way?
Things like opioids and meth and cocaine all work the same way by triggering dopamine, but they'll have different side effects. They can make your heart pound, make your teeth rot, make your skin and eyes become yellow.
That doesn't sound good.
Oh, that's just the start. Opioids also affect your brainstem, which controls your breathing. With every larger dose, the brainstem turns down the amount of oxygen it needs to function, until eventually it turns off entirely and you die from carbon dioxide poisoning. Dopamine is what motivates you to do things, but without dopamine, you wouldn't be motivated to even get out of bed.
So, no dopamine means no doing what gives you more dopamine. Is there any way to help her?
Hopefully she doesn't become addicted. If she does, it will take 1, 2, even 3 years for her body to start making dopamine on its own so she can feel like herself again. Speaking of which, it's been a little while. Let's see how Sheila's doing.
Sheila? You all right?
That was amazing. Can I have some for later?
I think she liked it.
You might be looking at the beginning of an addiction, my friend.
But she looked so happy when she was singing. I hope she holds on to her life high.
It's good to be alive. Feel the wind in my face. See the blue in the sky. It's days like this I realize what a gift it is. It's good to be alive.